Countries across the world are fighting a collective battle against the deadly coronavirus. Many have already evacuated their nationals from China, while others are in the process of doing so. Let's start with a quick check on the processes and the procedures that are being followed. The US has now issued a level 4 travel warning to its citizens. This means a strict no when it comes to traveling to China. All 195 Americans evacuated from Wuhan are being observed at a military base in California. One man who tried to leave the base has now been placed under quarantine. The US has also reported its first case of human-to-human transmission, with the husband of an infected patient contracting the virus. In South America, both Chile and Peru have announced preventive measures. Both the countries are yet to confirm cases, but as a precaution, passengers will be screened at airports. Chile has started to identify individuals who might have to be isolated and placed under observation. A specialized military cargo plane has been prepared to take off from Ankara to evacuate the Turkish nationals from Wuhan. The cargo plane has been specially fitted with medical equipment. It will be getting back 35 Turkish and 10 Azerbaijani nationals from Wuhan. According to reports, the evacuees will be made to put on masks during the flight and will only be allowed to disembark one person at a time, and also allowed upon landing, the plane will be moved to an isolated area off the airport, and the passengers will then be transferred to vehicles without any human contact. The crew and passengers will be quarantined for 14 days upon their return to Turkey. South Korea successfully completed the evacuation process. A chartered plane carrying 300 South Koreans from Wuhan landed in Seoul. The passengers will be placed under quarantine at two different facilities before being released. The country is reportedly planning three more flights to evacuate the remaining citizens. South Korea so far has reported cases of the virus, with close to 3,000 people who recently traveled to China under observation. Australia confirmed its ninth case of the deadly disease. The Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, announced that Australians returning from China would be placed in isolation at Christmas Island, a facility that is 7.5 hours away from the West Coast. Italy became the fourth European country to confirm the virus. Two Chinese travelers visiting Rome tested positive. Italy has barred all flights to and from China in a major precautionary measure. In France, a health professional who was treating a coronavirus patient has contracted the virus. The doctor is now being treated in an isolated ward at a Paris hospital. France has evacuated 200 of its citizens from Wuhan. The chartered plane is scheduled to land in southern France, where the passengers will be placed under quarantine for 14 days. On your screens now is a closer look at the extent of the virus spreading. Human-to-human transmissions have been reported in US, Germany, Vietnam, France. China has announced that it will be sending chartered flights globally to return the Wuhan citizens to the Hubei province. Most of the confirmed cases across the world are travelers from Wuhan. Joining us live from Hong Kong. Also joining us is our Pakistan Bureau Chief, Anas Malik. To you first, Grace, a quick update on the latest number of confirmed cases and the restrictions that have now been imposed.
Yeah, a big jump in numbers from China overnight, as usual. And now the spread, the number of people infected is more than the early 2000 SARS outbreak. And that's particularly concerning for a lot of the regions around China, like here in Hong Kong, South Korea, Japan. They've all been through the SARS outbreak before. The death toll at that time was particularly high, and so nobody wants to see that again. So we're seeing some extraordinary measures to try and prevent that from happening. Hong Kong has announced a state of emergency at the moment. Kids aren't going back to school until until March. Singapore has just announced that it will ban all travelers from China, including foreigners who have recently been to China. And so we're continuing to see this escalation in responses from nations afraid of the fact that this coronavirus might spread to other countries in a very quick fashion.
Right. And Grace, if you also speak about the shortage of masks and the chaos that has erupted in various parts of Hong Kong as a result of that shortage, what are the authorities saying at this point?
Yeah, masks are incredibly hard to find in Hong Kong right now at different pharmacies here. People are queuing up for 2 to 3 hours to possibly get their hands on one. Online, it's almost impossible to find as well. But it's not just Hong Kong. Japan, South Korea, even Canada and the U.S. are all reporting shortages of masks because of how authorities say that this is effective towards blocking the virus from entering your system. Now, there are other measures you can take as well, such as washing your hands and not touching your face. But overall, this is causing panic across several nations due to the fact that, you know, the masks are kind of seen as the only way to physically prevent the virus from entering your body. But health authorities say, you know, as long as you take care of yourself and make sure you stay hygienic, it's unlikely if you're outside of China at this point that you'll contract the disease.
All right, we're going to leave it there for the moment. Grace, thanks very much for that update. Indian students stuck in the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak, Wuhan, are now making their way to the airport. Special Air India flight, which is meant to evacuate the students and bring them back to India, will be landing in Wuhan shortly. Indian nationals are being checked before they board the boarded the bus, and the buses have also been screened throughout. The Air India flight B747 departed for China today. It will be bringing back around 400 citizens who are currently stuck in Wuhan. If everything proceeds as per schedule, the flight will land in India at about 2 a.m. tomorrow. Upon their return, all these 400 citizens will be placed under quarantine for a period of 28 days in isolation wards. These wards have been set up by the Defence and Labour Ministries along with the Indo-Tibetan Border Police. The government plans to quarantine most of the evacuees from China at the defence facility in Manesar, as it is located far from the residential areas. Isolation wards have also been set up in Delhi's All India Institute of Medical Sciences, or AIIMS, and RML Hospital. The samples of the patients will be tested at the National Institute of Virology in Pune. The evacuation comes a day after India confirmed its first positive case of the coronavirus infection. A student from the southern state of Kerala tested positive. The patient recently returned to India and is currently under isolation, set to be stable and under constant observation. Meanwhile, five more patients, including four men and a woman, have been admitted at the RML Hospital in New Delhi. They are suspected of being infected with the deadly virus. All five patients had recently returned from China and are now being kept in isolation wards.